Hey people, what is up? This is going to be a video about locking mechanisms on knives, on folding knives, and I'm going to tell you my opinions on them, and you know, show you some various ones, and you'll find out which one I like the best out of all of them. So, if you don't already know, basically, I'm going to try to do it in one video. Might not be able to do that. I only got 10 minutes, so I'm not sure I can cover what I want to cover in that. But if not, I'll do a two-part. So let's jump into it. Let's start with a popular one, the liner lock. Now this is a cheaper liner lock, Smith & Wesson SWAT, and it's got a very thin liner in it. Okay? You see that? It's a really thin liner. And basically, I can get this knife to close. You know, if you hit the back of it, it'll close without engage or disengaging the liner lock. I don't trust this. You know, it's gonna, the back of the tang on the blade here is very, you know, it's flat. A good liner would have the back of the tang would be angled, so the liner would nest into it without sliding all the way over this way, because I can slide this liner. If I pull back on the blade and slide over, that liner can go over farther and farther, and I can eventually get it to pop off the other side. So I don't trust that. It's just not a real stout liner. I mean, you know, for an EDC knife, maybe so. But for a hard use, you know, I wouldn't trust this one. So there's that. A little bit better liner is something like this. Okay? See this? Can you see the way the back of that tang is angled? That way the liner, as it wears out, you know, or wears in, rather, the liner will eventually, you know, start rubbing that metal and the liner, and they'll rub, and you'll get the liner going over a little bit more over time. But when they angle the tang of the blade like that, then it allows the knife to wear in better. It's still a slightly thin liner, but you know, this one, I trust this one a lot more. So, you know, and it's a good steel on the liner on this one. So, you know, this one is not. So there's a couple. How about the Kershaw Tone? Very thick liner. Once again, you got your slot angle, okay? You got your, I don't know if you can pick it up there, but there's a slot angle, so the knife can wear in better. And the liner engages right behind the tang, sets right up against it. No play. And this one would probably take a whole long time to develop any. So that's a good example of a good liner lock, in my opinion. Okay? Shit, hit the camera lay, why not? But, yeah, so, that's a good example. Let's move some of these off here. Another good example, Tenacious. See there? Just what I've been talking about. It's slanted, and it's got a thick liner, and it nests in there right behind the blade, locking it open solidly. So, that's a good example. Now, you have some other ones that are a little bit safer, in my opinion, like the Columbia River M18. And when you open it, okay, you have this little thing right here that you can slide forward. It's called the lock system, L-A-W-K-S. Okay, and what that does is when the liner engages, well, then you push that little button I showed you, slides behind the liner, so now the liner cannot disengage once that's forward. See there? So that's a better method, plus you got a good liner in here as well. Okay, so you take it off, you'll see that thing move away, and you can slide that over and shut your knife. A variation of that is the Auto Locks system. CRKT Hisatsu has this. Some of the others do too as well, or do as well. When you open it, this, instead of having to do it manually, automatically engages. Okay, watch. See that right there? When I flip it open, watch what happens. Flies forward, and now you see that little thing right there? That is automatically behind the liner. It will not let the liner go over any more than that until you pull back on this and slide it out of the way. I trust these more than your average liner lock. Now you have another one. This right here is not technically a liner lock because the frame of the knife is actually holding the blade, and the same frame that's holding the blade is actually where the liner or the locking mechanism is. These are just some little decoration slabs over it. So technically this is a frame lock. Okay, when you open it, you see there, the same part that's holding the knife together is where the lock is, where the liner is, or the frame of the knife. Basically same thing as a liner lock, except it's a lot stronger because the frames are usually thicker. Same, works the same though, you know, the frame jumps in behind the tang of the knife. So that's a very, very strong method, and you know, I trust a frame lock even more so than a liner lock. So there's that. I got another frame lock around here somewhere, but I don't want to dig that out. I already dug enough of them out. Let's move on to some weird ones. Okay, you got a Spyderco Q. And what happens here is you open the knife and you see that little cutout right there? This bar is going to drop in there whenever it opens. Watch. See that cutout? Drops in there. Now your knife is, you know, locked open. And you just raise it up like that and let it go. Just like that. That's not the strongest lock in the world, but it's adequate. I mean, it works okay. I wouldn't trust it for hard use. Another strange lock. You don't see them a whole lot. This is my Timberline Discovery. Okay, and basically what happens is when this knife opens, okay, there's a little bar. It has a circular cutout in the blade, and there's like a G sort of, and whenever the bar gets to the part where it's flat in there, it slams forward into it. So it's a circular cutout, okay? Rides around, and you know, it's hard to explain, but I'm not really sure if you can see it in there. Probably can't. My lighting is not directly over, but basically what happens is a bar slams in internally in the blade. Okay, bar slams onto a flat part, holds the knife open. When you push this, the bar moves out of the little portion and allows the knife to pivot around the little bar. Kind of like the Axis Lock, similar. Also, this works just like the Timberline. You know, very similar. There's a cutout in the blade once again, and I don't know if you can see it. See right there, there's a hole. It's a channel in the blade, and whenever this gets up there, look inside there. See that flat portion? Whenever it gets totally flat, you know, parallel, it's gonna slam in forward, and that holds it open. You gotta pull this back and allow it to rotate in that channel again. Now, you know, there's descriptions on it that are better than mine. If you want to know more about it, just look those up. But I'm just kind of showing you the locks. And those work similar to an Axis lock, but this does not have a channel on the blade. Rather, it has a flat portion up top. See there where it's unpolished, or uncoated, rather. There's a bar that goes across, and whenever this gets, you know, flat, that bar is going to slam in on top of it. See there? Now, it's holding the blade open, cannot close. Only when you pull this back and let that blade free will it close, okay? The Axis lock is a hell of a lock. So is the Cold Steel. These two locks are, this is called the Ultra Lock, by the way. These are two very good locks, okay? I trust these completely, but they're still not my favorite. And I can see right now I'm not going to get this done in 10 minutes, or, you know, roughly 10 minutes. It's going to have to be a two-parter. But anyway, these right here, another design. This is a classic design. And what it is, what you would call this kind of lock, is a slip joint. Okay? Basically, it does not lock. You see, you got a spring there and a flat portion of the blade, similar to how the Axis lock works. But instead of having a bar that goes across, you've got a bar like this. Kind of like a lock back, but it does not lock into a channel or into a groove. It just goes flat against it. When that flat portion right there in the blade gets parallel up under there, the spring slams down on top of it, putting pressure on it, and now the blade will not close as easily as it would if it was just, you know, swinging freely. But, you know, these have no locking mechanism per se, so you can just kind of push down and it releases the spring, pushes the spring up, and then it lets the flat part out. You can pivot it back around. So there's that, another example of that right quick. The little Spyderco, what do you call this, bug? And it's a little You can see a little spring moving up there. See that right there? Kind of hard to see. It just barely moves up. A little spring comes in. Same principle. Gets on that flat part. Boom. Locks open. So I'm about to cut and go to something. Go to part two. Be right back.